Welcome back to Let's Play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. I'm Mr. Math, doing this Let's Play for you. And I took the liberty of doing a couple of things off camera. The big one was that I spent those four remaining spirit orbs and got a slightly longer stamina meter. It looks like it takes five stamina improvements to get an entire extra ring. And while I was at work, so to speak, I noticed something interesting. Here's the Carusa Valley. That's where I was told the Yiga were, and sure enough. So I'm pretty sure now that I have to go down this way. It's a bit of a drop, though, so I'm a bit undecided at exactly how to do that. Should I take the direct route and just go right down the side here? Uh-oh. Oh. Terrific. Okay. Ow. Soldier's bow. That hurt. I'm wearing pretty good armor, too. I'm pretty sure I had full hearts before that hit me. I wasn't paying very close attention, I have to admit. So I could be wrong about that. So, do I want to go just straight down? Or do I want to take the longer approach? Well, let's compromise. I'll go straight down. How did it get so cold all of a sudden? Okay, fine. Let's. Okay, that healed me up and gave me resistance to the cold. Offering statues with absolutely nothing in them. I wonder if I put apples in all of them. You know, it looks like I have just enough. Yeah, let's do that later. Okay. I have to admit, I'm starting to get a little bit confused. I don't actually see much of anything down there. It's like this is supposed to be the way in, which is what I thought in the first place. Maybe I shouldn't be going this way. I just don't know what to do. Well, let's just keep going this way. If all else fails, I can just warp back to the shrine and go up from there. Coming from. Okay. I'm still getting the feeling that I'm going the wrong way. On the other hand, someone's trying to stop me. Okay, I'm starting to feel pretty confident that I'm going the wrong way. So yeah, back we go. Let's not be so hasty. Peppers here? That seems kind of odd. Oh dear. You know what? Yeah, I'm definitely going the wrong way. I mean, the marker's back here. So that's obviously where I need to go in the end. This is probably just the entrance. You're supposed to go in here and dodge the rolling boulders and wandering Yiga tribesmen and the like. And fight your way up to this, up to the goal. Okay, so fair enough. Although it still strikes me as a little bit odd that they would put a shrine here. Because that simply implies that you're going to need to come back here. Let's see. Okay, well, at any rate, this is Carusa Valley. Which is where I was supposed to go. And it leads right to the goal up here. Those things, I guess they're not exactly like Karoke clicks, but they sure put me in mind of a Karoke. Okay. So there must be something in here that I'm supposed to do. Wait a second, what's that over there? Doorway? Oh, I see. Yes, I'm starting to see. Torch. This looks like a doorway. Only it's sealed shut. Okay. Well, that explains a few things. Okay, I guess that's the way to go. But first, let's find out what's in the rest of these areas. A treasure chest, ooh. Money! Yay! Always happy for a bit of money. torch is badly damaged. Well, I don't actually need it much longer. And this should be the last one. Another treasure chest. Excellent. A sapphire. Ooh. I'm in your base stealing your treasures. Okay. Time to drop that torch. Now, this is the way deeper in. Six hundred. Oh my goodness. So there's the Druidal Guard there. Anyone else around? Not that I... Oh. I do not like the looks of this. Hey, what are you doing here? This is the hideout of those Yiga thieves who stole the Thunder Helm. If they spot you, they'll call their friends for sure. There's no way you can take them all on. If only you had some way of distracting them, but I don't know how. All I ever see them do is patrol and eat bananas. I haven't seen anything else you could exploit as a weakness. Listen, this place is dangerous. You should get out of here while you can. I can take care of myself. Yeah, you've done a great job of that so far, Barda. So they eat bananas. Okay, I think I can make use of that. I can distract him by dropping a banana along his path, and then while he's busy eating it, I can creep up behind him and do a sneak strike. Where am I keeping the bananas? There they are. Okay, and let's even the odds a bit more. Now, that's not what I'm looking for. Where's the here's the silent stuff. Not yet. Not yet. Now. Okay. What exactly did I do wrong there? Let me think. Okay, let's just talk to them, talk to her again. Just so that I can say I know about that. Maybe the business about eating bananas was a red herring. It seemed like it made him keep walking, which kept him ahead of me so I couldn't sneak attack him. Try this again. Okay. All right, how do I attract this guy's attention? Okay. Okay, how do I use that? I wonder what his field of vision is like. If I come at him from the side, wow, the banana mother load. Okay. I wish I could get over there. This is going to be pretty tricky. And I already expect it to be pretty tricky, but this, wow, okay. I saw that ladder right there, off in the distance, and I was thinking maybe it came up here, so I could go down here, but no. That would have been too easy. Yeah, I'm just not sure how to deal with this. Maybe I should retreat for now. Go back, do some cooking to get more stealth enhancements. That was close. Almost too close. Stealth is about up. Not good. This is the last stealth I have. Not good at all. Okay, let me see here. Let's prioritize getting that guy over there next. Because if I get him, then I can go over and get that guy on the right there. Okay. Let's use this now. If all else fails, I can retreat, make some more stealth items, and then come back. Okay, okay. Okay, let's take a good look at how this guy moves. Looks like he goes counterclockwise. Blast it. Okay. I'm out of here. Shoot. Okay, that was a bust. I still have silent shrooms. And let's see. Okay, I have silent shrooms and I have this blue nightshade. If I make dishes using both, oh, and these sneaky river snails. Okay, this is kind of disappointing, but stuff happens. Alright, where can I go to cook? Let's see. Well, right here. The stable next to Dueling Peaks definitely has a cooking pot. So going there, I can cook up all of these stealth items I have. And since I have multiple stealth items, I should be able to make some pretty good stealth elixirs. All right. Now then. Silent shroom plus blue nightshade, that's what I'm looking for. Silent shroom plus blue nightshade plus sneaky river snail. plus Sunset Firefly and a monster part. Okay. Let's see what this gets me. Only level one sneak? Oh. Well, that's better than nothing. Okay, then. That'll have to do. Now, there's something I want to check on before I end the video. Specifically, I want to go up the waterfall. To go up here is because there is one of those Korok pinwheels at the very top of the stables there, and I want to fly down there and check it out. While I'm up here, I might as well get these. A ruby! Woohoo! Now that's a good one. Now then, let's go over here. Okay, I thought I was gonna have to start shooting something. But I guess just getting up here is the challenge. Alrighty. Well, I guess there's nothing for it then but to head on back. Now this is interesting. This just might be the place where I need to go to check out the Shrine of the Seven Champions or whatever it was called. Haha. Well, that's for later. For now, let's head on back. You know, it's going to be a bit of a wrench if it turns out that the big Yiga guys have all respawned. But I guess there's really nothing for it. Anyway, I'm gonna drop a save here. Well, YouTube viewers, thank you very much for watching this far, and I'll see you next time on Let's Play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild as we proceed back into the Yiga hideout. See you next time.